What's up, people of the internet? I'm the Big Bolt here with yet another video. In this video, we'll be testing the NVIDIA GeForce GTX 1050 Mobile, which is a GPU based on the Pascal architecture. It has 640 CUDA cores and 4GB of VRAM in our case. We're using the latest driver suite as of the making of the video. I found a voltage using MSI Afterburner. You can see my curve here. This GTX 1050 Mobile is paired with the Intel Core i7-7700HQ, which is a CPU based on the Kaby Lake architecture that has 4 cores and 8 threads and a frequency of up to 3.80GHz. I found the voltage by -100MV, you can see my throttle stop settings here. You also have 16GB of RAM in dual channel mode, now source a small SSD for the operating system and a slow hard drive on which the game is installed. As for operating system, we're using Windows Xite Optimum 10 Pro version 2. All the specs are in the video description. It's Doom time! Let's go! The game that we'll be benchmarking today is Doom Eternal. One note to make. For some reason, the game has a weird texture and lighting flickering problem. I'm not sure what's causing it. Some people suggest that it's caused by the game version or the screen that you need to install a specific NVIDIA driver from 2022, but I mean, why would I install an old driver just for a single game? I found out that turning on VSync fixes the flickering, provided that you use settings that allow you to maintain 60 plus FPS all the time, of course. It's not like the flickering is epilepsy inducing, but it's really weird. Oh well, let's get straight to the point still.
Thank you. Thank you. we have created. Thank you.